Chapter 21. Dominic was too stunned to talk. As he leaned forward to have a closer look, he saw the initials S.C. scratched on the key. They were scratched in just the same way as the ones on his own lucky key. Before he could say anything, the Signora hurried them out of the room, whispering that Salvatore needed his rest. Dominic and Antonio followed Francesco as he carried Violetta up the wooden ladder to the attic. That was where Signor Gisella had laid down feather beds on the floorboards for them. All the while, Dominic stood clutching his bare neck, trying to make sense of what he had just seen. "Francesco," he finally whispered, "where did Salvatore get the key he's wearing around his neck?" Francesco shrugged. "He found that key last year in the churchyard. He keeps hoping that a pirate had buried treasure there, and that one day we will find the treasure chest that key will open." "What about the initials?" "Initials? On the key," Dominic exclaimed. "The initials SC. How did they get there?" His voice had risen to a cry. "Calm down. It's only an old key." "Just tell me about the initials," Dominic pleaded. "He scratched his initials on the key with Father Tommaso's pin," Antonio explained. "The one he uses for the altar cloth. But don't tell Father." "S.C.," Dominic whispered. "Salvatore Candiano." "Who else would it be?" Francesco replied. That night, Dominic stayed awake long after the others had fallen asleep. He was thinking about his own father's name, Sal. He had never thought that it might be short for something, Salvatore, say. And what would it mean if his father and Salvatore had the same first name? There was so much that he didn't understand. How did he get Salvatore's key? How did he get here in the first place? Who was the old man on the phone in the museum? And now, there was no time left to figure it all out before the other boys left for America.